Good morning. So I'm hoping you are feeling as good as I do because yesterday evening I booked my plane tickets back home to Sweden. I'm going back home for 1 week in February to visit my friends and family and eat some Swedish food. But now it's Wednesday and it's gym time. So I'm gonna check the weather and see if it's cloudy as yesterday and the day before that it was raining, but I'm hoping for good weather because I miss the sun. So let's check the weather. Yes, it's sunny today and it's blue sky, so I'm happy. So I have a gym membership here in Rome and it's just like 5 minutes walking from my house, so that's great. And they have like a lot of different classes. Usually back home at the gym I was a member of back home in Sweden, they didn't have any classes, so they only had those, you know, the gym area you go and work out by yourself. And they also had like a spinning room with like a big screen that you can put on like a class, I guess. It was like a spinning teacher, and it was, how to explain this in English, like someone had, like I guess someone had a camera on a car, like a GoPro on a car, and film like a route in the mountains in like Spain, France, Germany, and so it feels like you're biking in the mountains or in other places. So that was quite fun. So I really enjoyed doing those like spinning classes back home in Sweden. But here they don't have that like advanced spinning room. They do have a spinning room, but I mean, it's kind of boring just spinning there because you just stare into a wall. So I actually prefer going to the classes here. And they have quite a few classes. I have like a schedule for the gym and you see like it's quite a few classes they have. And I've tried a few of them, not all of them, but I have really enjoyed going on Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. And it's the same woman that has these classes. And it's called, I wanna see, Gym Tone. And I don't know how to explain like what kind of workout it is, but they have like loud music and we do like different, it's not like a dance or anything, it's more like you do movements with the music and also like a lot of squats and so on. Because on Mondays it's leg day, I guess, because we focus most on the legs and do a lot of squats and things like that. On Wednesdays it's arms and we have weights, so we use them for toning up the arms. And on Fridays, it's a little bit harder because it's like the whole body thing. And we use what I call like bell bars. It's called like the long sticks with the weights in the ends. We use them for like, I don't know, like lots of different movements and workouts. And thing is like, oh, I need to change arm. Good thing I'm gonna work out my arms today so I can hold up my phone. And the thing I like about going to these classes is because you get like motivated because it's someone there pushes you. And also it's like the same crowd there. It's always only women. I don't know why it's only women in these classes, but sometimes it could be someone in my age, but most of the time it's like women over 40 and 50 or even 60. And it's one of the women, she's so sweet and she's over 80. I can't remember exactly how old she is, but she's over 80 years old and she have like done some hip surgery, I think. And she's always there, and even though she can't do like all the workouts like properly, She always tries her best, and she's so sweet. I really like her because even though she can't speak any English at all, and I can't speak really that much Italian, but she always, say ciao to me and, try to speak with me in Italian, and I just, smile and nod. And there's also a few of the women, like two or three of them, that can speak a bit English, so they like translate for us. So one of the days, like one of the first days I was attending those classes, one of the women told me or asked me, "Where are you from?" And I said, "Sweden." And she told me, like, "Oh, but I'm from Sweden too, but in Swedish." And she asked me if I was here like working or if what I was doing here in Rome. And I told her I was here as an au pair. And she told me that she also started out as an au pair like 40 years ago. And she had stayed here because she found her husband. And so, I mean, that's so funny, meeting someone that's from the same country and has, started out the same way with au pairing. And now she has stayed there for like at least 40 years, I think. And goes to the same gym as me. That's funny. So, I think it's time to go to the gym now. So I don't want to miss the class because I really like it. So, let's go. So, I'm back from the gym. It was tough, but it was fun. And now I'm gonna make a smoothie for breakfast. And I'm gonna juice. Let me see. Spirulina and wheatgrass powder. Oops, now's the spirulina on the floor. And the thing is, usually I don't use powders like this, but it was, I guess, a few months ago or like 6 months ago at least. It was a bit before I went to Rome, and I had like terrible acne, and I was like desperate and didn't know what to do about it. I was researching things to do to get rid of acne, and a lot of people talked about, oh yeah, you can add like spirulina and wheatgrass, and I have like mica powder and lucuma powder or something, and I use them in smoothies. Honestly, it doesn't taste extremely good. But if you have it with like bananas and dates, you can't really taste it that much, so it's fine. But the thing is, I want to use up the powders before they go bad. So I don't want to waste it because I paid a lot of money for, buying the powders, and I know they're gonna go bad soon. So yeah, that's why I want to use them. And I don't know if it's helping with acne or not. I don't know if it's, I mean, my acne has been like, or my skin has been a lot better lately. I mean, I still get occasional like breakouts. I don't know, you can't see really in this lighting in this camera, but I still get spots. But I still have a lot of scars from my acne, but my skin is so much better now than before, and I don't know really what has helped it. If I'm eating better, or if I'm working out more, if I'm in the sun more, or if I'm drinking more water. I don't know exactly what it is, or like my skincare routine has been because I used a lot of products before, but now I only wash my face and I don't put any more products on it. So, but that could be a whole nother video about my acne, like my previous acne and everything, like my skincare routine. But yeah, I'm gonna do some breakfast. So while I'm eating my breakfast in bed, I'm watching Madeline Olivia on YouTube. And she's a vegan, and she lives in the UK. And I found her when I was doing a bit of research about the no poo method. And now she's like my favorite YouTuber. And she does a lot of videos about minimalism. And she clear outs her kitchen, her clothes, her bedroom, her living room, and so on. And that's very inspiring. And that makes me want to go back home to Sweden and clear out everything in my room, all my like clothes and stuff and things I don't need and don't use. It makes me want to, donate it and sell it and so on. So, yeah. So if you're interested in watching like videos like minimalism and so on, like you should definitely check her out. I can link her video or her channel in the description box below.
The things I'm like not sure about, and I'm like, oh, like my heels and some of my coats, I'm just gonna leave out and see.
So it's a couple of hours later, and I have showered and gotten dressed. So now it's time for lunch before I pick up the kids from school. And I have this leek that I need to use up before it goes bad. You can see it's start to get a little sad and a little brown. So I need to use this. And I also had a couple of yellow onions that was, you see, they are about to go bad. So I need to use them as soon as possible. This is fine, but this is a bit bad. And so I thought I could make one of my favorite soups. And I'm not the mastermind behind the soup. I don't know who I should give the credit to, if it's my father or his mother, my grandma, or who, I don't know who made this first. But nonetheless, both of them used to do this soup, and I love it. So, and before I was vegan, they did this soup, but non-vegan. And afterwards, when me and my sisters became vegan, both my grandma and my father have made this soup vegan. So, actually, when my grandma was here with her sister, they made this soup for like the last day they stayed here, I think. And I got the leftovers. We had it for dinner, and then I got the leftovers to put in my freezer. And just a couple of weeks ago, I ate the last of it. So, and also when my family was here, my father did this soup, I think at least 4 or 5 times for lunch or dinner, because everyone loved this soup so much. So, and it's pretty easy. So the things you will need to make this soup is one leek, and you don't need to have onions. My father used onions, I know, but my grandma don't use onions, so it's up to you. I just need to get rid of this, so before they go bad. And so I have two of them, and then some potatoes. I think like if they're in this size, you can have like 5 or 6 of them. If you have like a big, because I have a big leek, so I'm gonna do like a big batch so I can have for multiple lunches or dinners. And so I have one big, and then I have 4, 5 like medium-sized and a small one. So, and I also have this kind of like vegetable broth, I think it's called, or stock, vegetable stock. I'm not sure what it's called, but I have two of these I'm gonna use. And you're gonna need some sort of, or you don't have to, but it tastes better if you have some sort of plant-based cream. And I have this soy cream and a little bit of black pepper. So, let's get started.
And now I have chopped up all the vegetables and put it in the pot and just covered it with water. I guess it's around 1 liter water. And I'm just gonna bring it up to a boil. So now it's boiling and I'm gonna put in these vegetable stocks or broth or whatever it's called. I have two of them. And I think it's okay with two. Otherwise, if you taste them, and it doesn't taste as much, you can just put one more in, okay? And I'm also gonna put in some black pepper. And please don't do the mistake I did one time. I put in too much black pepper and it wasn't that great. So I'm gonna put in a little now in the beginning and taste it later and see if I need more. And now I'm just gonna let it simmer until all the vegetables are soft. So I'm gonna just check on the potatoes every now and then. And when the potatoes are soft, I'm gonna come back to you. So I think it has been about 20 minutes now. And I have poked the potatoes and checked so they are soft enough. And they are. So now I'm just gonna take the fork and press the potatoes against the walls of the pot to mash them. And I mean, you could use a mixer, what's it called, a stick mixer or so, to make a completely smooth soup. But I prefer it. First of all, I don't think we have a stick mixer here, and second of all, I think it tastes kind of good to have small pieces of potatoes and leek and everything. So I'm just gonna press the potatoes against the wall of the pot and I will come back to you. So I have now pushed most of the potato pieces against the wall of the pot, and that makes the soup a lot thicker. And you can eat it like this if you want, but to give it an extra little touch, I guess, I'm using the plant-based cream. So I'm gonna pour in half of this cream, I think. I don't know exactly how much I need, but I'm gonna pour some in and see how it looks. Voila, it's finished.
It's hot and it's good. And I have some more soup here I'm gonna eat now. Oops. And I put the rest in a big box. And I need to hurry up because in the 50 minutes I need to go to the train and go to the school to pick up the kids. So, bye! It's 10 p.m. right now and I'm babysitting. The parents are at a dinner or something, I think. And yeah, the last time I saw you were at lunchtime when I made the soup. And I can tell you the soup was delicious. I really think that you should make the soup and give it a try because it's a very good soup. And yeah, I still have a lot of soup left that I put in a plastic container and put it in the fridge so I can have it some other day. And after that, I went out and I went to the school to pick up the kids. And we went straight to the swimming pool because the kids had swimming lessons today. They go to the swimming pool every Wednesday. And when we arrived back home, we played a little and then we ate dinner, pasta as usual. And yeah, after the kids brushed their teeth and went to bed. So, and actually tonight we didn't have any internet in the house at all, but it's kind of good actually. I have done other stuff that not involve internet, and it's kind of good actually, kind of, because sometimes, or most of the time, I, like, when I stop working in the evening, I watch a movie, or I watch some YouTube videos, or I doing stuff on internet, and it's kind of good to do other stuff and not be, like, dependent on the internet, because I guess we have it all the time, every day, and I use my phone and my computer a lot, so I'm not gonna lie. And so yeah, it's kind of a good learning lesson, I guess, to not have internet every single day. But yeah, I'm gonna go brush my teeth and wash my face and go to bed. So yeah, I hope you tried the soup, and thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Hejdå!